there'll be someone after me, and so hopefully someone after them again. So it's.
And they couldn't prove that Fang was Sherwood Diller because I never meant for it.
These faces were reconstructed from nothing but the voice of a person. They are results of the software Speech to Face. They aren't perfectly accurate, but match the basic attributes. Your voice is part of your personality, and your voice reveals a lot about you. Where you're from, how old you are, your gender, your emotions. In short, your voice can be used to identify you. Humans are pretty good at this, but machines are even better. Computers can detect diseases like COVID-19 and Parkinson's through speech, with high accuracy. So if this is what small teams of researchers can achieve, how about multi-billion dollar corporations like ByteDance, which owns TikTok? This is Alex. He makes videos on TikTok. He didn't even notice that TikTok started to collect his face and voice prints in 2021 because the change was buried deep in the company's US privacy policy. Samira didn't notice either. TikTok collects data like her age, gender, and interests for advertising and behavior analysis. And TikTok might not be alone in this. Since voice-controlled digital assistants have become popular, it is easier than ever for corporations to gather voice data from millions of people. Call centers use real-time speech analysis to detect the mood of the caller as well as the employee.
Thank you for calling. This call may be monitored for tone and emotion.
This US collection agency, for example, uses analysis software that constantly monitors the employee's performance and notifies their supervisor if it detects dissatisfaction or heightened emotions during the phone conversation. Amazon even offers similar voice identification technology for verifying a caller's identity in real time. This software is supposed to replace security questions like date of birth or social security numbers. One major threat to voice authentication systems is the increasing capability of deepfake software. Free web tools for impersonating celebrities or popular characters are just a click away, and professionally cloning a voice is only a matter of legal limits.
Deepfakes are getting quite sophisticated.
How a person's voice is protected by law depends on where they live. For example, the European GDPR defines biometric data, like the voice, as a special category of personal data. This type of intimate personal data must only be processed under specific circumstances.
Boring!
Yeah, maybe, but legislation is the most effective thing to keep these companies in line. Privacy legislation might be the reason TikTok currently doesn't collect voice prints in Europe, but the company still collects the text of words spoken in videos. The United States might soon get their own federal privacy legislation with the American Data Privacy and Protection Act that is currently being drafted. It is also possible to defend your voice privacy yourself. Voice changing software would be one example that could be used for phone calls. Voiceovers for video are sometimes done with text-to-speech software, and many tools today sound much more natural than the early days of
Microsoft Sam.
There even is a voice privacy contest by an international team of scientists.
The goal is to develop the best voice anonymization software, and anyone can participate. You might ask yourself, is all this even necessary? I don't even use TikTok. Michael here doesn't use TikTok either, but I bet he didn't know that this drive-thru might just collect his voice recordings from ordering for similar purposes as TikTok. Voice privacy concerns everyone. Thank you to patrons Joe Bloggs, Danny, and all other patrons and subscribers for supporting the SensiClick channel.